Dan.
How are you, John?
Where you been hiding out? Sit down. Tell me all about yourself.
Well, ain't nothing much to tell, son. Been doing some repair work around the place. Kind of expected you out.
Well, I was figuring on getting out tomorrow night. Thought I'd try and even up that cribbage score.
Come ahead. I've got to run over to King City tomorrow, but I'll be back for dinner. Just drawn out all my money. I'm going to restock the ranch. Now that you're a sheriff, I reckon the rustlers won't be so active. I want the old place to look tip-top before Bess gets home next year. She's all I got, John. And I'm going to see she's comfortably fixed.
I understand, Dan. I'll do all I can to help. And I owe you a lot. You've been as close to me as my own father would have been.
Shucks, son, you don't owe me nothing. It's been great to see you grow up into a real man. You don't know how proud I was when you got elected sheriff.
I reckon I'll be drifting along.
Well, you better not waste that roll. You might not get home.
Oh, I'm all right. Nobody's going to hold me up.
Where's your horse?
Got him tied back at the express office.
Oh. Well, don't forget tomorrow night.
I'll be waiting for you.
There goes old Dan. We'll wait till he's well out of town. We'll slip in the back way when Pete's alone.
There was three of them, John.
Did you recognize any of them?
They were masked. They came in the back way. Surprised me. Got me in the shoulder.
Boys, get Pete to a doctor. I'll try and round him up. That money bag, Martin.
Hand me that bag. Thank you. Work your way down the creek back to town, ditch that stuff.
I got a slug in the arm, Joe.
We'll take care of that when we get back to town.
I've killed my best friend.
You were only doing your duty, Higgins. Why take it so to heart?
When duty makes it necessary to take the life of a man like old Dan Matthews, well, then I'm through with duty.
Well, there was positive proof that he was one of the gang. Clem here saw him tie his horse behind Wells Fargo. The evidence is too strongly against him.
Circumstantial evidence has convicted many a man, Dixon. And I still believe that Dan Matthews is innocent.
I'd like to see you at the office, Mr. Williams.
I'll be right over, John.
Well, Williams, I guess you get your old job back.
Well, my eyes are not as good, and my hands are not as fast, but I'll take the job until you can get a better man.
That's right. Fair enough, Williams. We need a good man.
Sit down, Ed. I'd like to explain something. When Dan Matthews left here, he'd just drawn all his money out of the bank. He was going to restock his ranch and get it in shape for his daughter, who's coming out this next year. Well, this money was on Dan when I found him. I wish you'd see that his daughter gets it. It's rightfully hers.
I'll keep it for her, John. No one will ever know.
Thanks.
Been about a year since Higgins left town now.
I saw him about 6 months ago. He was in town cashing in some nuggets. He's turned desert rat, you know.
Must have hit him pretty hard, shooting old Dan.
Never saw anything like it. He's like a dead man, walking around with the weight of the world in his heart.
What about Dan's daughter?
I had a letter from her a few weeks ago. Says she's figuring on coming out here soon.
Huh?
I think she'd be better off back east with her aunt. Same as I think John's better off out yonder.
Mm-hmm.
He's a strange feller, Bob. Howie hates outlaws. Says they're to blame for him shooting old Dan. Mm-hmm.
Mr. Johnny! And then why put your door?
Chenda, Annie, Chupik Chambe.
A broken leg, eh?
Oh, it's got
Well, don't try to talk, son. I'll have you in camp before night.
Black Eagle!
Ichimukechka ochka. Tolofa yathanas. Chohoda. Chinda ani chavik chumbi.
Kahuda amish. Big storm come. Tree fall. Kill him horse. Boy, hold him leg.
Oh, I see.
Son, go quick. You stay. We talk.
All right, Black Eagle. I don't know any place I'd rather be. Mighty nice of you to give me this ring, Black Eagle.
You keep me, my people, your friend.
Well, thanks. I won't forget.
Awfully glad to get home. You see, I'm Beth Matthews, and I own the Lazy M Ranch. There must be thousands of cattle, and at least 100 cowboys. And just think, I'm going to be boss. Oh, look at those wildflowers.
down. You drive? The town's about 3 miles ahead. Just stay on this road.
I don't understand. You're an outlaw, a killer. And you're letting me go?
Yes, and you'd better hurry.
And the last I saw of him, he was standing in the middle of the road watching me drive away.
Can you describe this bad man?
Well, I couldn't see much of his face. It was so dirty. Only a pair of steel gray eyes that seemed to look right through me. He had a heavy beard, a slouch hat, and faded overalls. He was the most horrible creature I've ever seen.
And his voice, do you remember it?
Well, he only spoke a few times, and I was so excited, I don't know.
Well, Miss Bess, you certainly have had an experience, but you must be hungry. There's a good eating house down the street. After you've finished your meal, I'll take you out to the ranch. I've got to get my boys started after Blake.
All right, Sherry. I'll be glad to get home.
Hello, Sheriff. Kind of surprised, Jay.
John, I'm sure glad to see you.
I just brought Blake in. The boys are taking care of him. There's your express money.
I might have known it was you. That young lady whose life was in your hands just left here. She told me everything. John, you and I are going to have a very serious talk. Sit down. John, that young lady is none other than Bess Matthews. She's coming back here shortly. I'm going to drive her out to the Lazy M. She thinks there's an income from the ranch. The money that we've got here, we'll need a cool head to spend it. John, that's your job.
I don't know. I'd never get away with it. She'd know it was I.
Well, who's going to tell her? She'll find out sometime, yes. But in the meantime, let's put the old Lazy End back on its feet. Just the way old Dan would like it.
Well,
what do you say?
I'll try, Sheriff.
Good. There's your room, clothes, and everything just as you left them. After you shave and clean up, no one will ever know you. Come out at the ranch tonight about 8 o'clock.
All right, Ed. I'll be there.
You've got the finest springs, the best grazing ground in the valley. And with John Higgins as foreman, why, you'll have the old Lazy M back on his feet in 6 months' time. That's him now.
Good evening, Sheriff.
Well, hello, John. Matthews, I want you to meet my friend, John Higgins.
I'm glad to know you, Mr. Higgins.
Thank you.
Won't you sit down?
The sheriff's been telling me about your thrilling experience.
Thrilling? It was terrific. That bandit was the most hideous, the most horrible creature that ever was born.
You don't say. A regular Bluebeard, eh?
Worse.
That's Aunt Martha. Best cook in the country.
Oh, I remember Aunt Martha.
Sure you do. She just about raised you.
Aunt Martha! Bess Matthews! How you have grown!
And you didn't forget me?
Certainly not.
Well, you shouldn't. I spanked you a plenty when you was a brat. John Higgins, I might have known I'd have to cook for you. Beth, you're getting the best foreman in the country, but the worst eater. He's got an appetite like a camel.
What do you mean, my appetite? It's a swell way you cook.
Oh, there you go, always flattering. And what's more, he leans back and breaks every chair in the kitchen. My goodness, you boys are sitting there without a thing to drink. Come on, Bess, we'll fix him some coffee.
See? Everything's working out fine.
Yeah, so far. How's it all gonna end? There's the end of the south pasture, Miss Matthews. Now I guess you've seen about all the ranch.
It certainly is big enough.
I'll pick up a couple of boys and start repairing the fences and see if I can't develop some new water holes.
You know, it's strange, but your voice keeps reminding me of...
Of Mr. Bluebeard?
Yes.
Well, I'm sorry, I might change it. I can talk up here like this.
Don't be silly. You know, that was the only thing about Mr. Bluebeard that was halfway human. Shall we go back to the ranch?
If you wish.
Well, Ed.
Hello, Bob.
How's the ex-sheriff making out at Lazy M?
Oh, all right, I guess. Been there 3 months, and he's worked out a deal with the government.
Uh-huh.
Want to raise horses and sell them to him. Made some dandy buys, too.
And Miss Beth, how does she like country and ranch life?
Crazy about it.
Yeah.
Courting Aunt Martha.
Uh-huh. Well, that's fine.
John, tomorrow night's Halloween. Aunt Martha says they're having the biggest dance of the year at Bolter's barn. Let's go.
I guess it has been kind of lonesome for you. 3 months now, and you haven't been off the ranch.
Oh, I haven't been lonesome exactly. I've enjoyed being with you. Our rides and evenings with the fire.
Oh, I've enjoyed them, too.
It's the first time you've said so. You've always been so strange and distant. Don't you like me?
Well, that's just it, Bess. Well, someday you're going to hate me. It's inevitable. And when that time comes, I'm leaving this part of the country for good. Now, you tell Aunt Marthy that I'm taking you two to the dance.
Someday I'll hate him. What's the matter with him? Why will I hate him?
Now listen, honey. All men act like jackasses when they're in love. That's exactly what's the matter with John Higgins. He's head over heels in love with you. But don't worry. We'll just let matters take their own course. Like this fella Spearshake says, all's well that ends well.
John says he's taking us to the dance tonight.
Yes, I know. He told me this morning.
He did?
Mm-hmm.
Like they're all going to have a good time.
Big night.
Good evening, Ed. Quite a crowd.
Looks like the whole country's going to be here. Got a match, John?
Yeah, I think so.
Where'd you get that ring?
That's a gift from old Black Eagle. I thought I'd lost it.
Miss Hawkins, meet Miss Matthews.
I'm so glad to meet you, Miss Matthews. I must have just joined.
Yes.
She
Sure is the belle of the ball, all right.
Oh, Beth, I want you to know Mr. Dixon.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Miss Matthews is boss of the Lazy M.
Oh, it's a pleasure to know you, Miss Matthews. May I have the honor of the first dance?
I'm sorry, but that's spoken for. But you may have the second.
Oh, well, thank you. I'm lucky.
I should say so.
I'll see you the next dance.
Just a minute. Now we're going to start this dance off with a nice, dreamy waltz.
I've saved this first dance for you.
Well, I hope I don't disappoint you. I'm not much of a dancer.
I'm terribly happy.
I'm glad. Being in a crowd must make a difference.
It's not the crowd. I'm happy because I'm in your arms.
It could only be like that.
Mighty strange dancing with her foreman. And he the man what killed her father.
Foreman?
Yes, didn't you know it?
No, that is funny.
How much?
$1 apiece. Hey, Baxter. Watch the door for a minute, will you?
Say, Sheriff, I want to see you and John right now.
John. Pete wants to talk to us a minute.
Sheriff, the Martin boys just gave me this new bill.
Let me see it. We've been on the lookout for these, John. That's got the same serial number. Those that were found when old Dan was killed.
What do we do?
Act like nothing's happened. This is the first clue we've had since the robbery. And I'll watch every move those Martins make.
Yes, indeed, Miss Matthews. Your father and I were very close friends.
Mr. Dixon, I've asked so many people about my father, and they've all evaded my question. Won't you tell me how he was killed?
Well, I really think you ought to know. You won't hold it against me if I tell you?
Certainly not.
Well, your foreman killed your father, Miss Matthews.
My... You mean... Mr. Higgins killed my father?
You see, he was sheriff at the time. He had the law behind him. They fought it out alone. There were no witnesses, so no one ever learned the truth about the killing.
That, you low food fool. You got to have your wits tonight.
Yeah, and a little courage.
You don't need any courage for this job. Beat the dance is all we have to do is break in and grab the money and beat it. The chief said wait till the milking contest's on, and there won't be anybody leaving. We won't be seen. Come on.
Now, folks, Valley will contest against Aunt Martha Hubbard, undefeated champion of Broken Bow.
You're the only one who's ever told me the truth. They've all made a fool of me. Please excuse me.
Left 10 to 22. Turn right.
Now keep the Martins here until I get back.
John! I must see you alone.
Well, I'm sorry, Bess. I can't see you right now. Well, please excuse me. I'll be back later.
Contest, are you, boys?
Well, you ain't missing the contest, are you, boys? Matthews?
Will you please take me home, Mr. Dixon?
Oh, certainly.
Money's in the sheriff's office, Pete. Those two will soon lead me to the third party. And then I'll wring the truth out of them about old Dan.
Aunt Martha, you'll please excuse us.
I want to speak to Mr. Higgins alone. I hardly know how to begin. But when I say I know who you really are and what you are, perhaps you'll understand. Why did you wait months to wear that ring, Mr. Road Agent? And tonight, with my own eyes, I saw you rob the Wells Fargo.
Followed me?
I followed you. And I found out that you're not only a bandit and a robber, but a murderer as well. You killed my father. You can't deny it. The whole town knows it.
I'm not trying to deny it, but won't you let me explain?
Explain? I wouldn't believe anything you said. You've lived a lie ever since you've been here. You were right when you said I'd hate you. There aren't words vile enough to express my contempt for you. Now get out of here. I never want to see you again.
Martin boys just went into Joe Dixon's place. They went in the back way.
Dixon? I wonder.
I tell you, Joe Higgins was the fella that got that money away from us 3 months ago. He had a beard and other clothes, but I knew him by the way he rode.
Well, anyhow, I cooked his goose last night. He's out of a job by now. You know, I don't see any reason why I shouldn't step in and marry the boss of the Lazy Inn.
She's sure a swell-looking gal.
Yeah, and she's got about 1,000 head of slick-looking horses in that south pasture.
Oh, that is news. Making a quick turnover, we ought to get about $8 or $10 a head. And with no stock on the ranch, the boss of the Lazy M probably will be glad to marry a well-to-do gent like myself. I'll ride over and get Brokaw. Him and his gang can help us with the drive.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Dixon's leaving town. I reckon I'll just follow him.
Head of horses in the south pasture of the Lazy M. All we gotta do is to shoe them off down to Gomez. He'll give us $8 or $10 a head without a squawk.
When do we start?
Dawn tomorrow. No one will even see us.
Black Eagle, I'm in great trouble. Men come tomorrow morning at sunrise to steal all my horses.
Men no steal horse. Me, my people, your friend, we fight.
Good.
Here comes Brokaw now. Take it easy, and when you get him running, push him through.
Here they come. Boy, what a surprise they're gonna get. Starting the first band out of the corral. Tell me, Martin, or I'll break every bone in your body. Who killed Dan Matthews?
He's up, I'll tell.
All right.
Dixon and me held up the express office. You chased us and shot me off my horse. I run into the cabin, and old Dan was there. He threw down on me and made me drop the money bag. Dixon saw him through the window and killed him.
Dixon? Take care of him, Sheriff. I'm heading for town.
got to tell you. Higgins and his Indian renegades rustled your horses. Me and my friends tried to stop them, but there were too many of them. Now, use your phone.
Why, certainly.
No answer at the sheriff's office.
Drop that gun, Dixon.
I arrest you for the murder of Dan Matthews. Blackie Martin just confessed.
Please. John's been gone nearly 2 months now. I wonder if he'll ever come back.
Why don't you ask him? There's one fellow that might be able to tell you where to find him, and that's Chief Black Eagle. Squibbs, your new foreman, can take you to him.
His place over there.
Thanks. I won't be long.
Beth.
She's been in there 2 hours already.
Maybe she gonna live there.
Yeah. Women are sure queer critters.
Me hungry.
Me too. Say, what's the sense in a fella starving himself to death for some locoed female? Let's get the heck out of here.
best of pals. Me and my pony, we love all the gals. Me and my pony, we love to ride along, listening to the coyotes and a prairie song. Oh, pony boy, oh, pony boy, you're the one for me, you're my pride and joy. Me and my pony, we're the best of friends. We'll see each other through till the bitter end. Me and my pony, we love to go to town and watch the people as they stand around. Me and my pony, we love to round the strays. Then when our work comes through, we love to hit the hay. Oh, pony boy, oh, pony boy, you're the one for me, you're my pride and joy. Me and my pony, we're the best of friends. We'll see each other through till the bitter end.
Hey, Davy, look at him over there. Whenever Alibi gets to kicking up the dirt, you can bet he's fretting about something.
I sure am. What are we doing here anyhow? Cowhands on the Box C Ranch. And what for?
Because Dallas Conroy invited us, that's why.
And she must have had a very good reason. Handsome.
Nobody invites us anyplace unless they're in some kind of trouble. And we ain't seen none yet.
Well, we might. And you can bet there's a lot going on around here that we don't know about.
If anything does happen, we want to be right here on Box C Ranch.
Well, you can hang around here if you want to, but I'm going out and find something to do before I break a toe kicking up that dirt you're talking about.
Kind of fidgety, ain't he?
Yeah, he gets kind of itchy.
Sounds like trouble's found us.
You're not a kidding. Come on.
Do it again. Massacre them. Blow 'em down. Yippee!
Fella can get to be a right good shot when he's got the proper sort of a target.
Well, is the war over?
Can we just finish it, Dallas?
Then I reckon one of you gay caballeros can drive to the station with me.
I will.
You boys ought to get together oftener. I had a wife and dad. He's arriving on the morning train.
Well, Dave, while Dallas and I are in town, maybe you and Alibi had better round up those strays. Come on, Dallas.
Dusty, you're getting mighty fast on the reach.
any trouble, Alibi?
Yeah, some fellas rode past me like a cannonball before my morning's work. Been some sort of trouble brewing. I meant to ride over and have a talk with your boss, Conroy.
Well, he's getting home today.
Well, then I'll come over and see him right now. Looks like these strays I rounded up are straight again, so I'll ride into Box C with you. Come on.
Conroy, you're lucky to have the range busters to help you.
Yes. My daughter got them to come here and help us out for a while. She met them in San Antonio last year. They're a nice bunch of fellas, Richards.
As I was saying, since I started selling beef to the Army, I've run into all sorts of trouble, such as herds being mysteriously stampeded, 10 or 15 head cut out at a time and disappeared. I even found one of the water holes poisoned.
There's a war going on in Europe, and they're aiming to get us mixed up into it.
Don't mind Tad, Mr. Richards. He did a couple of hitches in the cavalry, and he still thinks he's war-minded.
By the way, the boys have been shooting at Mussolini and Hitler the last few days, you'd think we was already into it.
Maybe Tad's right, Tom. You was away fixing up some business with the government, wasn't you?
Yes. I'm going to ship 400 head of horses as soon as possible.
Where are you shipping, Tom?
You'd never guess. To the Philippine Islands. And I'm going to have to send my own crew along. It'll be quite a trip for the boys.
I imagine.
Here we are, right here.
Just a dot on the map.
Sailing, sailing over the bounding main.
And pay no attention to him.
Wait till you get him on board. Fellas, here's where we'll probably take the boat.
Where's that?
Galveston.
Oh. Galveston.
Galveston.
Gosh, that's a long way from home.
Well, do you think that's far? Look at this. About 6,000 miles of water to cross before we reach Manila.
Hello.
Oh, hello,
hello,
Alice.
I hope you boys won't be seasick all the way across those 6,000 miles.
Oh, no, they only get lovesick.
It's a long wait, Dallas, but if the cavalry needs horses in the Philippines, we'll get them there.
I guess you'll be glad to get away from the ranch for a few months.
Oh, no, Dallas, we don't want to go.
Oh, we want to go, all right, but
Well, make up your mind.
Is this the spot we're heading for, Dusty?
Oh, no, Alibi. Here it is. This is the island of Bali.
Well, couldn't we stop off there for a couple of days?
Why?
Get me? When I get a line on this trouble, I'll be letting you know.
Oh, it'll probably turn out to be some disgruntled cowboy trying to get even for something that never happened.
I hope that's all it is.
Hey, looks like we're going to have an official visitor.
Yes? Come in. Howdy, Captain.
Are you Mr. Conroy?
Yes. Well, you're from the 4th Cavalry.
That's right, Anders is my name.
Well, I'm glad to know you indeed. And this is my neighbor, Mr. Ken Richards.
How do you do, Mr. Richards?
Hi. I did 2 hitches in the 4th myself.
Oh, really?
Yes. Company D.
Well, good. And the toughest, meanest top kick in the entire outfit.
My friend, Tad Tilson. The slowest and dumbest bugler in any outfit.
Oh. I've been assigned to look over some horses you're sending overseas.
Well, you work fast, Captain. I only got back from Washington today myself.
We need fast action these days.
I'll call my foreman.
Oh, Dusty.
I'd like to have you meet Captain Anders. Dusty King.
How do you do, Mr. King?
Captain.
I've come to check over Mr. Conroy's horses.
They're over in the north section. When would you like to look them over?
Just as soon as possible.
That's fine. I'll saddle up and be with you pronto.
Right.
Captain seemed pleased with his inspection of the horses.
Well, he ought to be. Conroy's got one of the finest herds I've ever seen.
Wonder when we'll start driving him to the loading corral.
I imagine we'll find out this afternoon when we meet Conroy down at the railroad yard. Well, I guess we better be going, Davy.
Something wrong?
Well, it's those tire tracks, Davy. You know, this is about the spot that Alibi said he had the trouble with the truck.
That's right. Maybe we can find out where they're heading.
Well, we got a little time. Let's do it.
Okay. Hey, look.
Hey, wait a minute, Davy. Don't you believe in signs?
Sure I do, but we're still going to find out where these tracks lead to.
Well, all right, have it your way, but we haven't got too much time. When they hung out that sign.
We better get into action.
You said it. Davy.
Let's go back and try and pick up the trail.
No, we haven't got time now.
We're not going to let him throw lead at us and get away with it.
Now, don't forget, we promised Conroy to meet him at the railroad yard.
You go meet Conroy, and I'll try and follow him alone.
Well, now, look, Davy, that shipment for Conroy is really important.
All right, you win.
Take that hot head of yours and put it under a cool shower.
Come on, let's get back to the railroad yard and get that horse business over with.
Right.
Hi, Mr. Conroy.
Where are the boys?
Well, they'll be along a little later. After we made arrangements with the railroad, they stopped to spot the loading cars. Where are you heading for?
We'll try to round up those trays I lost the other day.
Well, I hope you have luck. We'll be loading next week.
A big job, herding 400 horses all the way to the Philippines.
You'll be tickled to death. We'll break the monotony of ranching.
Oh, we did want to go west. This time, I guess, there'll be plenty west. Get any mail for me?
No, I'm nothing but bills. For you?
Well, I'm glad of one thing. I'm just about even with the world.
How do you mean you're even with the world with all those bills?
Well, just about as many as I don't owe.
Oh, alibi.
Well, I'll be back by sundown.
All right. Here, drop him off the barn as you go by, will you? Letter for you, honey. Meant Margaret.
Did Dusty and Dave come back with you?
No, oh, they'll be along pretty soon. Say, I'm beginning to believe that you're in love with both those boys.
Father, how could you?
Where did they all come from?
Boss, you called?
Some mail for you. Hey, how come you get so much mail?
Plenty, big family. Father, he have 20 sons. All sons have 10. 15, maybe 20 children. Plenty big family.
That isn't a family, that's a whole settlement. Do you write to them all?
I write one letter, make plenty copies.
What you need is a printing press.
Me like he one very much.
Well, you save your money and you can buy yourself one. But you better get back in the kitchen there. The boys will be along pretty soon and they'll be powerful hungry.
Make it plenty good.
Yeah.
That isn't the truck alibi described. My eyesight's getting bad.
It's heading straight for Hidden Valley.
Yeah, and if it gets there at that speed, we'll be hunting strays for a month.
Let's head them off.
Fine, how do you do? Come on, let's get it out of here.
Hey, what's the idea of this?
This is open rangeland, mister, and we figured you're driving too fast. We don't want any stock killed.
Now, take it easy, Dave. Let me handle them.
Get up your hands. Now, come on. Now, get down off of them horses. Now you start cleaning up this mess.
Ah, he didn't get far.
Looks like I run into something.
Get down off of that horse. And don't touch that rifle. So put him in the truck.
I ain't a hankering for no ride.
Shut up. You got into this, and now you're going to stay in it.
Not very long. Drop those guns. I said drop them, mister. You better start herding, Alibi.
First time I ever herded coyotes.
Get a rope. We got to deliver them somewhere.
It'll be a pleasure.
Let's lock them in the garage.
Good.
Get rolling.
Use my rope to hang yourself.
Well, that'll hold them till we need them.
Let's have a look at that stuff.
What's going on out there?
Boys, come back. Bring plenty of friends.
Why, there's a truck in the yard.
Let's go and see.
That's funny. Rifles and dynamite.
Wonder what he figured he's doing with all this stuff.
Well, it wouldn't be for any good. Hey, these rifles are made in Japan.
Japan?
Mm-hmm.
You know, if that truck's had a load of rifles in it every time he's seen it, Dave, well, they could arm every enemy alien in the country.
Right.
Well, be a pigeon-toed centipede.
Alibi, you better get over to Captain Anders and tell him what happened right away.
All right, I'll take the station wagon.
Beep, beep.
Oh, no, you don't.
Well, why don't I get it?
Because you can't drive any better than a locode steer.
The last time you drove it, you smashed two headlights and a fender.
Yeah.
Well, my foot slipped that time.
Well, slip your foot into a stirrup and get to Camp Morgan, Alibi.
Well, okay.
I'll get back as fast as I can.
Hey, alibi! Keep your mind on your work!
What are you buckaroos doing? Fixing for war?
We just put in a war.
Who'll be fighting?
Farmers, boss. The same gang that stampeded alibi strays.
And we got them all locked up nice and safe in the garage.
I haven't the faintest idea what you boys are talking about. And I don't think Dad has either.
Well, I'm blessed if I have.
Well, go ahead, Dusty. Tell them.
Well, when we saw this here truck going lickety-split for Hidden Valley, well, that was when the war began.
Yeah.
And after Dave got the drop on him, why, it wasn't any job at all to herd him into the car.
You're short and snappy. You'd have enjoyed it.
I always miss the good things. Well, we'll take care of these hombres army style. We're all doing guard duty tonight. 4-hour shifts for each of us.
I'll take the first one.
Hey, what are you doing up?
I can't sleep, Davy. I've been hearing funny noises.
Oh, you'll be all right.
What? Why didn't you cut me in on it?
Well, I didn't want to bother you.
I'd like to get in on these things, too, you know. Oh.
Take your time.
Horses all saddled.
Goofy, think of everything. Horses, go, where truck no go.
Those range busters got that load of rifles and our explosives.
Huh, but they don't know what we have stored away.
But then we'll find out big things.
Hey, this is foolish. Tad's on guard.
Well, I'm still worried.
For some exercise before breakfast.
We're gonna get it. Come on.
Charlie.
Hello, Captain.
Well, who's this little gargoyle?
Did you hear that? He called me little.
Well, now don't get sore, Elmer. This is Elmer Sneezeweed. Elmer, this is Captain Anders.
Hi, Elmer.
How do? Captain, I could have been in the Army if it hadn't been for my feet.
What's the matter, Flat?
No, cold. They want me to be an officer.
Well, why weren't you?
Oh, I wanted to see some of the fighting. But my old man was an officer.
Well, what's that make you?
Officer's mess.
Well, I hope our enemy agents are as easy to handle if they're brought back.
Oh, don't worry. Their escape is only temporary.
I hope they're caught. Mr. Richards, Alibi explained you'd had some trouble at your ranch. That's why we stopped by and brought you along. Tell me about it.
Well, there's nothing that I can put a finger on exactly, but I'd sure like to take a look at these men.
Oh, the boys will have them back before we finish breakfast.
There won't be no breakfast.
No breakfast? You just send Cookie to me.
I can't. He's vamoosed.
What?
His room's all mussed up. Found these letters half burned in the cook stove.
What do you make of these, Captain?
A letterhead of the Japanese Tourist Bureau. We know that's an espionage agency. And these are all postmarked Japan.
Well, he told me he was a Filipino boy.
He fooled you. He's a Jap. I think that explains the escape of your prisoners and his disappearance.
You mean we've been harboring a spy?
It looks that way.
Well, that sounds like the boys are back.
There they are.
I told you they'd get them. What'll happen to those men, Captain?
I'll turn them over to the FBI. Our job is soldiering. Conroy, you know, I wouldn't be surprised if we get to ride those horses you're shipping to the Philippines.
How's that?
Well, don't tell the boys, but I think I'll be in...
Hello, Dave. Want to sit down? Only four more days. Aren't you excited about your trip?
I can't make up my mind, Dallas. Mainly on account of you.
Sweet of you, Dave, if you feel that way. Because I need you.
Do you really mean that?
You can do something for me. Something terribly important.
I'll do anything for you.
Then look after Dusty for me. But he's not as self-reliant as you are.
He isn't?
No. I don't want anything to happen to him.
You don't want anything to happen to him? Oh. I guess I understand.
I knew you would, Dave. But please don't ever tell him what I've said.
Ain't likely to.
Why, that's Dusty.
Yeah, that's Dusty.
Hello, Dusty.
Oh, hello there, Dallas.
May I sit down with you?
Why, sure. This is an unexpected pleasure.
Only four more days. Aren't you thinking about your trip?
Well, I'm not so sure, Dallas. Maybe I'm thinking about you too much.
I'm so glad, Dusty. If you really feel that way.
I've felt that way ever since I first met you.
Then you'll do something for me? Something terribly important?
Anything you say, Dallas.
Look after Dave for me.
Huh?
He's not as self-reliant as you are.
Oh. Oh, he isn't?
No, and I don't want anything to happen to him.
I'll sure see to it, Dallas.
I knew you would, Dusty. But please don't tell him what I've asked you.
That's another thing you can be sure of.
Better come on, Dave. Dusty's going to sing.
Sing? I thought he'd finished.
I'm a leaving Cheyenne. Goodbye, old Pink. I'm a leaving Cheyenne. Leaving Cheyenne. I'm off to Montana. Goodbye, old Pink. I'm a leaving Cheyenne. Old Pink's a good pony. He paces when he can. Goodbye, my little pony.
What are you doing to those two boys?
I just want to be sure they look out for each other.
I thought you were after some of your monkey shines.
You ought to be ashamed. I love them both.
Well, I
guess that's true.
I'm a leavin' Cheyenne. Oh, hitch up your horses and feed 'em some hay. My wagon is loaded and rollin' away. Leavin' Cheyenne, I'm off to Montana. They won't eat your hay. Good morning, young ladies. I'm rolling away. Leaving Cheyenne. I'm off to Montana. Goodbye, old paint. I'm a leaving
of a really perfect day.
Dave?
Yeah, Dusty?
How do you feel about going away?
Oh, I don't know. Got a bigger job in my hands than I expect.
You should know the job I have.
It'll be hard work loading those horses on the boat.
Sure is.
Night.
Night. Gosh, I hope there's room enough for us on board.
Oh, you and I have a very nice cabin. Poor Alibi has to sleep with the horses.
Well, if the horses don't kick, I won't.
You could have knocked me down with a feather when I found you here ahead of us.
Yeah. Seems like only yesterday we were in Texas together, Captain.
The Army sure works fast.
You've done a good job, man.
Thank you.
I reckon we'll mosey around and see the sights tonight.
Go ahead. Have a good time.
First we'll eat. I'm starved.
So am I. How can we order? We don't talk Filipino.
Well, the sign for being hungry is the same in any language.
Come on, let's mosey. See you later, Captain.
Bye.
Attention.
Elmer.
At ease.
So long, Captain.
Hello, boys.
Oh, yeah.
I have a nice table for you. Waiter.
Something you like?
You fellas know Home on the Range?
Oh, yes.
Well, that's swell. Would you mind playing it? Oh, give me a home where the buffalo roam, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day.
Balay, balay de tu salma, di na mo sa ang mga kanding nagdula, din mo madunggang ang purong malaway.
That botam.
Balay, balay dito sa uma, di nang usa o mga kambing nagdula, hindi mo madunggan ang pulong malaway,
and the skies are not cloudy.
See what I see?
Cookie. Well, what in thunder could he be doing here?
Let's find out.
We're heading for trouble. This is a job for the FBI.
You're right, Alibi. But if we took time out to notify him, Cookie could be on his way to Tokyo.
We can take him over to Army headquarters and let them handle him.
Mila's waiting upstairs.
You wait here.
I'd better go after him.
Yeah, and we'll probably have to go after you. Go ahead, and we'll keep our eye on the other one. I think we ought to report this to the Army. But I am hankering after a little excitement.
Maybe we'll be lucky and get it.
Here, Miller. The plan for your trip has been taken care of as usual.
Are you ready to leave?
I am always ready.
You will receive a phone call. The man's name is Ken Richards.
Ken Richards.
With him, you will pick up our work.
Fine. I'll go now. You notify Tokyo that I am joining our agent.
Well, if it isn't Cookie. You know, we all wondered what happened to you.
What are you doing here?
Well, believe it or not, I dropped 2 cents and rolled right under these curtains.
You heard what was said.
Oh, yeah, I heard, and very interesting, too.
Appreciation for us rounding up a herd of spies.
They caught him all but Miller, and he got away.
Yeah, and he's the most important one.
Davey, are you sure you heard the name Ken Richards up there in that room?
Certainly. He's tied up in it some way. Miller's taking a trip. Hey, I've got a hunch Miller's on his way to meet Richards. I know this much. Their plan is to dynamite our vital harbors.
Better tell that to the FBI.
How can we? I heard him all right, but who's to prove it?
Well, we started this job, and we're going to finish it.
We got to head straight back to Texas and check on Ken Richards.
And corral him Texas style.
You said it.
Hello, Captain.
Yeah. Hello, how are you?
Big under army protection doesn't permit you to wreck everything in sight. That was disgraceful behavior. Unfortunately, there's nothing the Army Command can do about it. You may go, Corporal. Confidentially, that was a swell job. The way you routed out those spies, and now they're all in the hands of the FBI.
Oh, well, that's swell. We was kind of wondering why that would land us in jail.
Yeah, we've never been in jail before. Only twice.
Well, we must maintain discipline. And the way you wrecked that cafe, it was a work of art.
Well, I reckon now, Captain, that we've had our excitement, maybe we could be heading for home, huh?
Why, sure. I came here to release you.
We're sorry about the cafe, Captain. We're sure glad Cookie isn't talking to Tokyo anymore.
Better wait here, Alibi, just in case.
I got you.
Come in.
Hi, Mr. Richard.
Hi, boys. Be seated. Well,
Did you have a pleasant trip?
We had a mighty educating trip.
That's fine. Tell me about it.
We met some friends of yours.
Friends of mine?
Mm-hmm. Cookie. Mr. Conroy's Jeff Cook. Remember him?
Is this some sort of a game?
Could be. Cookie had some friends that knew you, too.
In fact, one of them was coming to...
Maybe you boys better make yourselves a little plainer.
All right. We will. We're on to your game, Richards. And it's losing one.
Because you and Miller are not going to destroy our harbors or anything else.
I reckon you boys never should have done any traveling.
Put your hand back on that desk.
Quick, isn't he? Now, coming back to that sabotage deal.
If you're smart, you forget about that. And lay down that gun.
Get the other gun, Richard.
Get over there.
The boys just returned from Bataan. They're very well informed.
And there's only one thing to do. Maybe you're forgetting you're in a civilized country.
People vanish even in this country.
Alibi. Did they get Elmer?
Never laid a hand on him.
Who's Elmer?
Oh, they're bluffing. Get your hands up. Let go!
Yeah, but I had to wing him.
Oh, good.
I'm thirsty.
I'm spitting cotton myself. Alibi, carry us a pail of water, will you?
Well, how do you expect me to carry it in my teeth?
Well, here, I'll untie it for you.
Oh, leave him that way. He'll be just as helpful.
I wouldn't doubt it.
Quite an account here of how you boys corralled those spies and discovered all of that dynamite hidden on Richard's place.
He sure prevented a disaster. And just imagine, not wanting a medal for it.
Stingy? That's why I never get the funny paper.
Well, who's going to drive me to church?
I'm just the man for it.
Enjoy your trip?
Wasn't that gentlemanly?
Never mind, I'll...
We interrupt this program to bring you a news flash from the War Department, Washington, D.C. Pearl Harbor, Hawaii has been bombed by Japanese planes. No further news is available at this time, but there's no doubt that Japan has started actual warfare. For further details, keep tuned to this one.
Well, that settles it, Mr. Conroy. I guess I'll be right.
That goes for me, too.
I'll be a pigeon-toed centipede if they're going to leave me behind.
That's fine, boys. And this time, we're all the way to Tokyo.
We'd better hurry. We don't want to be late for church.
Thanks, folks. We'll be seeing you.